Destroy the communication points to prevent the full force of the tower's security being alerted to your presence. Underground parking lot, 9:45 p.m.
That guy with the blood is heading for the upper floors. Before you follow, we'll need to get some insurance. Destroy the tower's communication point. You don't want everyone knowing where you're at.
Keep rocking, baby. Next location is Aomori. This is gonna be a match to remember. Fight!
Hadouken!
match to remember. Fight! Get 'em, boys!
You can run, but you can't hide, Augie.
No problem.
He's over here!
Looks like I got more company. The container will make good cover. Shadow, go see what you can do. Shadow! Slate, I have a gunshot victim. No pulse. I need an ambulance immediately.
Roger that. We'll notify Hope General. Any ID?
Victim's name is Slate. Frank Slate. He's my dad.
Sorry, Jack.
I'd seen 100 bodies sprawled ugly in dark alleys and bright living rooms. Augie Blatt's had a regular room at the Den of Iniquity, a prime hotspot for criminals ever since the Flaming Mamba Lounge got struck by Italian lightning. It wasn't the sort of place you'd expect to find a beloved philanthropist like Augie Blatt's, but then most people didn't know him like I did. He may have the city fooled with his goodwill money thrown at public parks and playgrounds, but apparently my dad was the only one interested in where that money came from. Drugs, mostly. Drugs and racketeering.
Jack, what are you doing here?
I could ask you the same thing.
Hey, working for your dad is fine and all, but he hasn't been able...
Since past. In an age of darkness, when the earth was overrun with demons and humans were powerless under their rule.
Thank you.
What's with the bird, Harry?
She's one of Charlie's specials.
Specials?
Special people with special jobs. She used to be on the game until she found her true calling.
What the fuck are you talking about, Harry?
She does the wet jobs. Charlie says they never see it coming from a bird.
What? She's a topper?
Oh, yeah, mate. She's not the slightest bit squeamish about a bit of claret.
What the fuck do we need someone like that on a job like this? It's meant to be a simple frightener. We pick up the bird, we pick up the kid, and we take him to Charlie.
You going soft eyebrows? Getting scruples, mate? Don't you know things have an habit of getting complicated?
Complicated? What can be complicated about picking up some bird and her kid?
They're on their way down. And what are you looking at? Oh, nothing to say. Good. Fucking Charlie. Said I'd be working with professionals, not a bunch of bloody has-beens.
Shut it, here they come.
What, let's do the business then.
Watch and learn something. You move when I tell you to move. Well, wait till they've locked the door. The first rule, never leave the transaction an obvious route of escape. Let's go.
Transaction? Christ, what a bitch.
Your dad told me you might be captain of the squad this year. I'd be proud of you then, eh?
Mrs. Hammond? Could we have a word? We've got a few questions we'd like to ask you.
Yeah? Who's asking?
We'd like to discuss this in private, if we could.
You're not the police. Since when the police start dressing like common tarts?
You bitch!
Run out!
Get him in the car! Run. Move!
Shut him up!
Zeus!
Ah! Idiots! Bloody amateurs!
Come on, get in the car, quick!
Zeus!
Get off me!
Go!
Don't worry, Suze.
Get our boy back.
Shh.
Get our boy.
Suze!
Oh, my God!
Susie!
Crisis Street.
They must be inside.
What's all that about?
I don't know. I've got a bad feeling about this.
Let him have it now.
Get the hell! This guy's a nutter.
How you feeling now?
Salmon, over here. Lads, get out here. What's happening here? We can have some of this, son. He ain't moving.
I'd expect the surfers going to thrash the boat a little bit and throw their boards everywhere, and there's going to be wax all over the boat. There's a certain dynamic that starts to happen between everyone on the boat. Most of the time, everyone's kind of taking their turn and trying to relax and get a feel for the trip and how they want to approach it. Every once in a while, everyone will surf together, but you start to find that some guys go out and surf sessions together and other guys will wait on the boat. You know, you don't really care about having a great boat as long as you're getting good surf. Yeah, back in 93, I was in Japan in Miyazaki and had a chance to go surf in the wave pool in the wave house. It was pretty interesting. The wave only comes from about 30 feet away from you, and then it wedges together in the middle of the pool, and the thing just dredges. It just sucks out, and it's a really hollow wave. It's actually a really surprising wave for a wave pool. Surfing isn't as easy as it looks. To stand up, you'll... Way to go. Yeah, back in 93. It's not too bad. You can, if you don't mind cold water, you can get away with a pair of trunks, but usually wear a spring suit. Donovan, Frank, and Ryder might use like a beaver tail wetsuit. There's always a lot of photographers on the beach and people filming and a lot of people in the water. One wave could have 10 guys taking off, especially on a good day. You know, you might have over 100 people on one peak. Survival of the fittest style. The left's a short, sort of steep wave, real good for aerials. It's always been regarded as one of the best aerial waves in the world. And the right is long, and you can probably do, you know, 10 or 12 maneuvers on it if you go all the way. Lower trestles is the hotbed of talent for all of California. I live in Cocoa Beach, about 35 miles north of Sebastian. When I was a kid, the water used to come all the way up underneath the bridge, and you had to park just on sand, a sand lot. And we used to ride our mini bikes around. It's just a marshland, basically. And there's lots of mangroves and mosquitoes, water moccasins. My dad owned a bait and tackle store, so we grew up fishing, and that's how we would spend the weekend, just go to Sebastian and just camp out and fish and dive and surf. There's always been a really intense lineup. There's a real pecking order at Sebastian, I'd say, as much as any wave I've ever surfed anywhere around the world. I can remember when I was a kid, I was about 10 years old, and actually I was begging people to let me have a wave. It just, that's how Sebastian is.
People, we've got a red ball situation here. Victim's name is Joe Gustafson. Killer is Andre Serena. Suspect runs a large catering facility, which is where the murder goes down in 37 seconds. Barry, what's our ETA?
30 seconds, Chief.
Let's go save this guy's future. Serena, freeze! Damn it, he's getting away. This door is locked up tight. I need another way through.
There's a maintenance...
Andre Serena. You are under arrest for the future murder of Joe Gustafson. Barry, give the man his hat.
No!
Danny Whitwer, FBI. John Anderton, I presume?
That's right. What can I help you with, Agent Whitwer?
Okay. These are my men, Ben Mosley and Ken Nara. We're here to take a little tour of your facilities.
Everybody gets the same tour. In fact, there's some kids upstairs right now who are about to start.
You misunderstand. I have a letter from the Attorney General granting me full access to pre-crime. She's concerned about your little operation going national without checking for possible flaws.
There are no flaws, Agent Whitwer. We haven't had a murder in 6 years.
Chief, you'd better take a look at this.
Excuse me. I have a job to do.
Maybe you better sit this one out, Chief.
They're looking for flaws. We're not gonna change the game plan now. Okay, break it down for me.
The killer is Nikki Jameson, last ID'd at Soul Enterprises, where she works as a consultant. We can be there inside 2 minutes.
I'm going to have Agent Mosley accompany you on this run.
This is my operation. You answer to me. Clear?
Crystal.
I want everyone to secure the building. Barry, you're with me. Ben, you've got the front door.
Can't do that. I need to see how you work.
Son, this is how I work. You will follow my damn orders and guard that damn door like a bear guarding its cave. Understood?
Greetings, Nikki Jameson.
Welcome. There she is.
Right behind you, Chief.
Security systems reprogrammed.
That doesn't sound good.
Careful!
Medium left. Get her back on track. Headed right. Easy left. Hard right. Careful, your door's on. Hard right. You won't finish like this. Hard left. Bonnet damage. Rear bumper damage. Jump ahead. Hairpin left. Pay attention. Easy left. Easy right. Hairpin left.
Looks like the freak wants to play. What's with the getup, chump? Hey, you!
If you press the R3 button, you'll enter look around mode. In this mode, a targeting reticle will appear, which you can aim with the right analog stick.
Something's in town? Who's that? and he's fast!
Let's face it, there's nothing more embarrassing than getting whacked by some thug you lost track of. If you press the L1 button, you'll lock the camera view to your enemy.
My Uncle Ben and Aunt May raised me like a son. They never had much money, though. I thought my powers could help make up for that. The last time I saw Uncle Ben alive, we argued. I took out my frustration in the ring. Poor Bonesaw never even saw me coming.
No more Mr. Nice Guy!
The fight promoter cheated me, so I didn't think it was my problem when he got robbed.
Somebody! Stop him!
12 Henry, call back on that 187 in connection with the carjacking at the 42nd Street Library.
10-4, suspect is believed to be a member of the Skulls Gang. Proceed with caution.
Murdered. I have to find the guy who did it. There's nothing Peter Parker can do at this point. But Spider-Man is a different story. This is supposed to be the Skulls' territory. I'll find Uncle Ben's killer if I have to go through every one of the Skulls to do it.
Who's that? Oh! Hey, you!
Here's a tip for when you're on the side of a building.
Circus in town?
They didn't know anything, but I'm just getting started.
Thank you.
Mace, I've got power readings ahead.
I see them too. Power up forward shields.
Mace, I'll concentrate on the turrets. You take care of the rest. Coordinates for the first anti-orbital cannon. We must move quickly. Follow me. Master Windu, there's the first anti-orbital cannon. My sensors indicate several enemy units moving on our position. This is not going to be easy. Almost destroyed. Stay on target. One down, two to go. Master Windu, I've input the coordinates for the second anti-orbital cannon.
Let's go.
Watch your fire, Mace. There are some supplies nearby. We can use them to recharge our concussion missiles in outer hull. Hellfire droids on my sensors. Be careful, Mace. Their missiles are lethal. Mace, you're straying from our objective. We need to stay on target. Target.
Preparing for final approach. Whatever's causing those transmissions, it's not showing up on any of the sensors. This Imperial outpost looks as abandoned as reported.
It's as dead as the rest of Ketchum. Mon Mothma must be getting paranoid. She never used to send pros like us out on blue milk runs like this.
Kyle, Jan, greetings.
Mon Mothma, Kyle was just talking about you.
No doubt. I bring troubling information about your mission on Ketchum.
I hate it when you say troubling.
I think I saw someone.
See if I can find a way to get the door open. Wait here, Jan. See if I can find a way to get the door open. Wait here, Jan.
Perimeter defenses online.
Did that do it?
No.
Stay here, Jim. Cover our back.
Okay, I'll wait here. Don't take all day.
your hot ladder, it is going down. Running, shoot, street boot, just b-ball. No running and shooting today, man. You know what I mean. Let's go ahead and get it started. Let's get it crackling right now. Someone's going to get hurt. Have you seen this ball back in? Not four.
Basketball never been seen like this. Two of the wickedest teams will be taking the court, so don't go nowhere.
Have you seen him get the ball at Knoxville?
Battling, straight up battling is what I'm provoking. But I'll die before this whack MC infects me. Hip hop industry to the point I cannot breathe. But if Wild Child dies before Wild Child wakes, I pray to God to step down and take down all the fake MCs. Pretty please.
I
got the vibe. 1-2 check, 1-2 the wild with the style. Check, 1-2 check, 1-2 check. Straight from the bass onto the kicks. Not freestyling MCs, fall down straight in the pits. My name is Jack, spontaneous freestylist when I get wrecked. Brothers rocking so hard, saying my rhymes I ain't wrote yet. So I take it to the max, take out fake funk and jacks. Get to the point, as a rockable man, live up in tracks. You used to get busy at open mics, nah, I still do. I kill crews, lyrically, spiritually, yo, I will do. Anything it takes to bring me boy style back. Anything's for you to make you say my rhyme style's back. But I'll die before this whack MC infects me. Hip hop industry, to the point I cannot breathe. But every Wild Child dies before Wild Child wakes, I pray to God to step down and take down all them fake MCs. Pretty please. I got the vibe. 1-2 check, 1-2 check, 1-2 check, 1-2 check, wreck the ride. Hell yeah.
Officer Tom is running for chief of security? You've gotta be kidding! Wall right up the walls, then wally up and grind the banners down.
I like Oh! Goodness gracious! My car! They're stealing my baby! Try to stop them!
We have some breaking news!
speaking to you live from this fantastic stadium. Welcome to today's featured exhibition match between the USA and Germany. It's the visitors to kick off. Short pass. Closer. Keeps it simple. Geisler! Excellent stop by the keeper. Puts it away! Germany take the lead. There's the easy ball. Janka! Good tackle. Hamann! Fabulous stop by the keeper. Releases it with a throw. Good stop by the keeper. Throws it out quickly. Sana. Gets tackled.
Chubby Wubby, this is Hubby Dubby. Are you there?
Yeah, I'm here. You're not saying I look chubby in this, are you?
Oh, shut up. It's just a code name, Chang.
Destroy the armored car and get the goods. mission failed.
I promise you, this is gonna hurt a lot. Now, the fun begins. Gonna bleed ya.
Had enough, mon ami? Losing's not my style.
What now? Hand over the pendant, boy! Hand it over now, and I'll let you leave here alive.
Pendant? You want this?
Don't do it!
Huh?
Well, what's it gonna be?
You can't give it to him! It's too important!
Hand it over! Now!
No! I won't!
Well, if it's going to be that way, then die! Where to run now, boy? You idiot! He's behind you! Quickly, after him!
Max! This way!
I was so scared then, but in a way it was really fun. I mean, every boring day had been just the same for me. But this was the beginning of a real adventure.
I'll take my chances.
You okay?
Yeah. You saved me, Donnie.
Hey, don't mention it. What happened out there? Who are those guys?
Flotsam Circus Troupe.
Why are they after you?
I think I heard something I wasn't supposed to. I didn't understand exactly what was going on. But I needed to get out of there.
Yeah.
Donnie, what is this place?
It's the underground water channel supplying the town.
Really?
You could also call it my secret base.
Oh, I never knew this place existed.
So what are you gonna do?
Underground water channel. So this goes outside of the town, right?
Hmm? Yeah, I guess.
Exactly.
Hey, Max, what are you cooking up?
Something's going on in the outside world.
What?
That Flotsam guy is threatening the mayor.
What? Why?
I'm not sure myself. But Flotsam said it. The whole town's living a carefree life, not knowing what's going on outside. What does that mean?
Don't know.
But after Blackstone Railroad went out of service, no one's left town. And it's not that they don't leave. They can't leave. The reason why the mayor doesn't open the gate must be so that people don't see the outside world.
Yeah, I guess you're right.
I'm going.
Huh? Going? Where? You're not thinking of...
I'm leaving this town.
Oh, hold on there. Seriously? But there's all kinds of weird creatures in the channel.
I'll be fine. I usually use this to fix things, but it makes a pretty good weapon, too.
No use trying to stop you now. Hold on a sec.
You know, being small and made from stone has some advantages.
It does?
Absolutely. I can climb up any stonework surface. Now that's something that might be useful to us, don't you think?
I guess.
Scree, could you give me some help here?
Damn that wind!
Uh-oh.
Don't panic. They can smell fear, you know.
You're not on the menu here. I'll smell how I want.
It's Hearn. Don't worry. I can speak the demon tongue.
Del Safinta, Dwend em Jen, Eb em Ota Jimen Diarella, Eb Hivan Keferai, Ekta Sansetem Rekba.
This runt would have me believe you're an envoy of the goddess Arella. You look more like a sniveling half-breed to me.
Scree, I vote we're big enough to swallow the odd insult here.
Strangers, in these treacherous times, should I drive you from my kingdom or leave you to the Maokai?
Trust me, Lord Hearn. We're here to help you.
Help me? I suppose you must know the whereabouts.